I'm in northeast Greenland and I'm visiting some caves in Grottadalen at 80.4 degrees north.
National Geographic explorer Gina Moseley is one of the many scientists working to address climate change.
I'm aiming to collect samples of calcite that you find in caves.
So have we got enough sample?
We've got two.
And from the calcite, I will go on to construct a record of how the climate has changed in the past in this area.
Calcite is a mineral found in cave formations, like these stalagmites that rise from the cave floor as material drips down.
The different layers are like tree rings or different layers in ice cores, and I can use the different layers to construct a record of climate change for this region.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Like geologic time capsules, these formations help Gina see into the distant past. Throughout geologic time, global temperature and carbon dioxide have had a close relationship. As atmospheric CO2 levels fluctuated, temperatures and climate followed suit. The oceans store carbon dioxide and help regulate global climate. And paleoclimate change happened slowly. This slow pace allowed species to adapt. Past warming events have caused massive and abrupt climate change. However, our planet is currently warming at a much faster rate.
No one has constructed a cave-based climate record for Greenland before, and I think that's just because caves containing calcite, they're so remote.
Ice core samples from Greenland have provided some of the greatest understanding of climate. The cave samples Gina's team collects will add to the data provided by the ice cores and allow Gina to create a more extensive paleoclimate record that will improve the accuracy of climate change and response predictions.
From base camp, we walked for 3 days to get to the caves.
3 days and we're still walking.
The terrain at the caves was very steep. It was like walking on marbles. It was quite tricky.
Studying paleoclimate change is vital to understanding human-caused climate change. Many scientists now believe that the extreme global warming event that occurred 56 million years ago was caused by enormous, long-lasting volcanic eruptions that released massive amounts of carbon dioxide and other gases into the atmosphere. This caused what is known as a greenhouse effect, when carbon dioxide and other gases block Earth's heat from escaping the atmosphere. Rapid warming was triggered, which caused ecological havoc and led to extinctions of some species and an accelerated evolution in those that survived. While climate change of today is not caused by natural events like volcanoes, it is still the result of too much carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases emitted into our atmosphere, this time by humans. But the effect on our environment will be similar, making Gina's work extremely important.
The best part of my job is that I get to go and see these absolutely amazing places in the world and from them produce something that is hopefully valuable to all of us in the future.